We start our day with the name of Allah Almighty, who is the most gracious and the most merciful. Welcome to all of you in the online session of KPS Schools. I hope you will be fine and you are exciting for your next lecture. It's a time for your computer class. As we have started unit number 6, which is about Boolean algebra, let me explain. Boolean is a set with only two values. These values are true or false. And in Boolean algebra, only two variables are allowed. These are 0 and 1, where 0 represents the false statement and 1 represents the true statement. We can also use three operations in Boolean algebra. These operations are addition, multiplication, and complementation. Today we will explain the terms Boolean constants, Boolean variables, and Boolean expressions. First of all, we will discuss Boolean constants. It can be defined as a Boolean constant can have two values. It may be true and false, where true value must be equivalent to 1 and false must be equivalent to 0. As you can see on your screen, two statements are given. In the first statement, 2 plus 2 equal to 4. This is a true statement, that's why it is equivalent to 1. And the second statement is 4 is an odd number. This statement is false, that's why it is represented by a number 0. Boolean constants always gives us two values, which are true or it may be false, where 0 represents the true value and 1 represents the false value. For example, if a set B has elements 0 and 1 with operations multiplication and addition is a Boolean algebra, then the elements 0 and 1 are called Boolean constants. Next is Boolean variables, which can be defined as a variable that can take only the values 0 and 1 in terms of true and false, then these variables are called Boolean variables. Boolean variables are used to save a value, and this value may be true or it may be false. For example, a Boolean variable is old enough saves a true value. The name of the Boolean variable must also be good because it expresses a fact that should be true or false. You can see some names of Boolean variables. Boolean 0 and Boolean 1 do not represent the actual numbers, but instead represent the state or some logic level. As you can see the difference between these two numbers, 0 and 1, as we know that 0 represents the false statement and 1 represents the true statement. Similarly, 0 represents the off term and 1 represents the on term. We can also write 0 in terms of low, no, and open switch, and 1 can also be written in terms of high, yes, and close switch. By observing both these logics, you can say that 0 represents the negativity of any situation and 1 represents the positivity of any situation. If the given statements are true, then it will be represented by the number 1. And if the statements are false, then it will be represented by a number 0. If we write the statement Boolean x equal to false, then we can say in this statement Boolean is a keyword, x is the name of the variable, and false is the value of this variable. We can also write 0 in place of false because 0 represents false statement. For example, if a set B has the values 0 and 1 with operations multiplication and addition is a Boolean algebra, Then the variables x, y are called Boolean variables because these variables are assigned with the values 0 and 1. Now we have to discuss what is a Boolean expression. A Boolean is an expression that evaluates to true or false. This expression is used in a conditional form and it consists of the following relational operators. These operators are equal to, less than, greater than, and not equal to. By using these operators, we can write the statements. As you can see, the first statement 10 equal to 10, this is a true statement and it evaluates to true. That's why we can say this is a Boolean expression. In the second statement, 5 is less than 7. This statement is also true. The relational operator less than is used here and this expression is evaluates to true. That's why this is also a Boolean expression. Similarly, in the next examples, relational operators are used and these expressions are evaluates to false. That's why all these are examples of Boolean expressions. Here we discuss some precedence rules. These rules are used to solve the Boolean expression. First of all, evaluate all the complement operations. If there is a complement in the Boolean expression, then first of all, the complement operation is solved. Secondly, evaluate all the product. After the complement, the product operation is evaluated. And in the last, we solve the addition operation. In this way, we can solve the Boolean expression. An example is given here, whose statement is x complement into y plus x into z complement plus x into y complement, where the value of x equal to 0, y equal to 1 and the value of z equal to 0. First of all, we will calculate all the complements. As the value of x equal to 0, so its complement will be equal to 1 because complement give us the opposite term. Similarly, the value of y is 1, that's why its complement will be equal to 0, and the value of z is 0, so its complement will be 1. Now we will calculate all the products. First of all, we will write the first term from the given equation, x complement into y. The value of x complement is 1 and the value of y is also 1. So the product of these two terms is 1. Now we will write the next term, x into z complement. The value of x is 0 and the value of z complement is 1. The product of these two terms is 0. Now we will write the third term, x into y complement. The value of x is 0 and the value of y complement is 1. So the product of these two numbers will be 0. Now put all these values in the given equation, we will get the required sum, which is equal to 1. You can see two questions on your screen. You have to do these two questions by yourself as an assignment. I hope you will give your best. Thanks to all of you for your cooperation. Allah Hafiz.